To Councillor Charles. Councillor Morrison, would you like to read your question or would you like to take it as read?
Thank you, I'd like to read it.
Please do so.
At a previous council meeting, we weighed up the need to do more about providing and facilitating warm homes. Since then, temperatures have plummeted, sometimes to well below zero, forcing all of us to find ways to keep warm. For people already struggling with everyday bills, forcing terrible choices between heating and eating, it's now a whole lot worse. Justin Welby, Archbishop of Canterbury, says action is possible, so we need not despair, though some may feel some despair. Acknowledging, these are his words, the real hardship and pain experienced now, he backs the warm welcome campaign involving faith groups, charities and businesses which let people in to keep warm. Harlow Playhouse was considered as an option and is undoubtedly a wonderful versatile building, may not be ideal, as I think you recognise. What progress has been made in providing warm banks for Harlow people to help them in their hour of need? It's certainly time for an update.
Thank you, Councillor Morrison. Councillor Charles.
Thank you, Chair. Helping to keep people warm this winter is something the council takes seriously. This authority believes it has a moral obligation to help the hardest hit by the cost of living. The adverse weather conditions this week highlight that it was the right decision by the council to open Playhouse as a warm space for vulnerable residents to go. Because of the facilities available at the Playhouse, free hot drinks can be served and representatives from local support services can be on hand to provide guidance in a warm and friendly environment. There is a coordinated approach to manage the impact this winter. Essex County Council has rightly opened the doors of the town's library for people to use as a warm space too. Streets to Homes is continuing to provide similar support to those in the town who are currently homeless. The council is working with other public services, community organisations, and the voluntary sector to identify other warm spaces in the town. If these warm spaces meet the council's criteria for supporting vulnerable residents, they will be included on the council's dedicated webpage for information about such facilities and be included as part of the ongoing social media campaign. Posters and flyers are also in production to be distributed. The council plans to provide access to a suitable room at the Luckenbush Centre as a warm space by the next week. The cold weather protocol triggered when temperatures are forecast to be lower than 0 degrees for 3 nights has already been activated and is in place for those with no place to stay during freezing weather temperatures. This means accommodation is offered by the council in collaboration with other organisations in town to keep people safe. As work continues to review the potential for other communal spaces in the town to be used as warm spaces, the council must assess if they offer the right facilities, are accessible by public transport, or within an acceptable walking distance for residents to use. The community hub, run by Rainbow Services, is also providing support and referring cases to specialist agencies for additional help if required. Council is keeping its approach to winter challenges under review and will take steps to adapt, where appropriate, to offer the best possible support to those struggling this winter that it can.
Thank you, Councillor Charles. Councillor Kay Morrison, do you have a supplementary question?
Yes, I do. Thank you very much, Councillor Charles, for that information, measures that are badly needed in this extremely difficult time. I know that these matters are very close to your heart. I know how seriously you take all of this. Would it be possible to provide a further update, given that the work is ongoing?
Thank you, Councillor Morrison. Councillor Charles.
Chair, I can. As of this week, Councillor Morrison, I'm grateful for that question and to be able to provide a further update. Council officers have been looking at a range of locations so that we achieve a wider geographical footprint of warm spaces in the town. That is our ambition, And what will then happen, as those spaces meet the council's criteria that I set out in my response, they will be uploaded onto the website. Currently we have a number of locations. Churches, of course, are doing a fantastic job, as well as Streets to Homes. But there are other organisations in conversation with us. There is the potential for another facility in the town centre, which the council is in close conversation with that charitable organisation, because that could be a potentially important community asset. And so we will endeavour to provide further updates to councillors and the wider public. But I am conscious, and as you said, that this is a matter of great concern for residents across the town. There are many vulnerable residents that have been impacted by the adverse weather over the last few days. So it is incumbent upon us as an authority to provide more warm spaces. We're working to do that and work with others as we work on a collaborative basis. So I'm grateful.